Welcome to Boomhauer69's channel, and today Boomhauer is going to be doing another talk video here. It's going to be basically about why I joined YouTube and just kind of a random talk, but the reason why I joined YouTube is because I thought it would be a great way for me to become a somebody and try to become successful in something, you know. Because in the past, I wasn't very successful at anything, and so I got to thinking, well, I'll try YouTube and see if I can become successful, because I watch YouTube videos all the time, and really got to like, and I thought, you know what, why don't I try making a video and see what happens, and so far, I like the outcome, you know. Now, the biggest struggle for me is really trying to build up this YouTube channel with little to no money. I basically gonna be flat out tell you, I have no money to really kind of, I guess, say, like, make travel videos and do a lot of the videos I talk about and stuff, because all that stuff costs money. But the reason why I keep doing it instead of just like stopping and waiting until I get, you know, is because I want to be able to encourage people, you know, that are in the same predicament I am, to prove to them that just because you might be broke or not have a whole lot, that you can still become successful if you try, you know. A lot of great inventors and wealthy people, they started from rock bottom and then became successful, you know. They started from the bottom, now they're at the top, and they became successful, you know. Like a famous singer, Eminem, the rapper, Eminem. He started out in Detroit, poor kid, and worked his way up into the rap world, you know, becoming a rapper. He worked his way up, and I want to be able to prove to people that, you know, you can do it with... You can become successful if you have little to no money, you know. Don't give up. It's just about keep trying, you know. Figure it out what it is you want to do. And then figure out what steps you need to take to accomplish that goal of becoming what you want, you know. Me, my personal goal is right now is to build up this YouTube channel where eventually I'm making decent money off from YouTube, and where I can become a somebody and then be able to have money to help other people out and maybe someday start up my own business as well and become successful, and where people that haven't seen, that know me personally and never seen me in a long time would down the line would say, wow, I remember when you're just this broke, poor old hillbilly person living in a little run-down shack of a house, and now look at you, you're well-to-do and stuff, you know, and that's my ultimate goal, you know. And it can be hard at times, because with my money situation, I simply have no money. I actually, the last job I had recently, I got fired from it, because, you know, they're struggling to make ends meet, so I was low on the totem pole, and they had to let me go, you know. They go by seniority and had to make cuts and done for. But I'm still in the process of fixing that issue. But that's a struggle. But I'm still going to keep working on this YouTube channel. And who knows, I might become well-to-do with this YouTube thing where I don't got to worry about trying to figure out what would be a good job to do on the side and stuff while I'm trying to work on this YouTube channel and stuff. So it's a little bit hard, you know. I'm glad that the YouTube, the Facebook real videos I do make a little pocket change on that, so I'm grateful for that little bit of income, but yeah, it's just right now I'm keep doing it and keep trying to come up with videos and stuff, and I, the last few videos, I kind of felt like I just put out a kind of silliness, you know. I tried to train myself not to just throw a video out there. Really try to make one that's going to really gather people's attention and really get people to want to watch a video. Because that's a little hard for me. Like these talking videos, I'm always kind of afraid of a little bit doing them because I don't want to just talk and then people kind of like, I don't care to, you know, like, where they just lose interest in watching the video, not watch, because I want to, my goal is to also try to make good talk videos and good videos in general of where people will want to watch from start to finish and stuff, so. And I understand some of these talk videos I do, oh, Good Night Alive, 10, they're over like 20, 30 minutes. One time I think I even did one that was almost 40 minutes. So I understand, you know. But, yeah, and that's my ultimate goal is to, right now I have no money coming in, so I'm trying my hardest to build this channel up and make it into something. Because if I can, and I keep trying and trying, because I feel like it's a way to encourage other people that are out there that might stumble upon my channel, you know, that have no money as well, they're working a dead-end job, they're stuck in a rut, and they feel like they get nowhere, that maybe they'll see my videos and see how I am and say, hey, if he can try to become successful, so can I, you know, with little to no money. And it's to encourage people, you know, that's one of my goals with this YouTube channel, is to encourage people out there to become a somebody. Just don't sit around on the couch being the mopey, moping around saying, oh, I'll never do this and I'll never do that. You know, I've been there. I've done it. You know, I had a father that was a little bit kind of like that, where he was kind of like, oh, you can't do this. Oh, you can't do that. And he just kind of a little bit gotten a little bit of a, I guess you'd call it depression. A lot had to do with the way my father was, is after he lost my mother, his wife, the love of his life, he kind of, I think, went in a little bit kind of in like a sad kind of depression, you know, state. Because after my mother passed away, he kind of, I think, went a little downhill, but understandable. But besides that, because my father was one of those, you know, he worked many years in a factory job and didn't really make it really nowhere in life and stuff. And so my goal is to try to better myself than what he did, and make that he's gone, passed on now. So with my mother, they're both passed on, and where they're looking down, and they'll be proud of me, kind of thing. But yeah, my ultimate, and that's why I want to encourage people to basically, I really don't know where I lost my train of thought here, where I was going with this, but it's basically my goal is right now with Lil' Nomai, keep doing this and try to really prove to people that, you know, you can make something of yourself even if you ain't got no money. It's basically what it is. And as, again, like I say, as time goes on, the more money I get in my world, the more funding and stuff. I call it funding. I don't know why, but I just, but anyways, the more money I get, the better the videos will be, you know, so, and stuff, and I can do more and stuff. But it's a little bit of a challenge right now, but, you know, but then again, you know, there's like these people, you know, there's videos out there, there are people reacting to stuff, and, you know, people just getting online, looking up videos, and then doing the reaction to it, and they're making tons of money, so, you know, it's a challenge, but it's a fun challenge. It's one of those things I sometimes shock myself. You know, I'll make a video thinking, oh, this video ain't gonna do worth a darn, and then realize, wow, that video actually done quite well. Like those videos I did on my father's knife collection, that one on one little bear knife video I did of the, it was a knife that was light blue and kind of had like gold brass colors to it, and it had pictures of a bear on it. And I'm like, I'm on Facebook Reels right now. That's a pretty popular video because that's one of my most popular videos. And I'm like, wow, people actually like that video. And I was kind of shocked at that. That's one of those videos where I thought, oh, this ain't going to do very good. And then I was like, wow, it did a lot better than I thought. So, yeah. But that's one of the things. That's, again, my main reason for joining YouTube a lot is to basically show the world that you can become something with little to no money and become successful, you know, being at the bottom and top, you know. It's a struggle. I even struggle from day to day, you know, thinking, oh, I wish my channel would grow a lot faster and all that stuff. But it takes time, you know. You gotta remember it takes time. And I'm a big one that forgets about that, you know. But in the end, it will work out and it will be successful. Now, for future videos, ideas, and stuff, I thought about doing is maybe right now, since I can't afford to buy certain products and stuff that I like to show and kind of talk on my channel about, I thought about just going to the pages, going to the websites, you know, getting on my computer, going to the website, showing the product, like the ad, I guess you'd call it, the web page ad of it, and then explaining why I find this product interesting and maybe doing a talk about that in the future and stuff. Like, I happen to saw on this one website that sells a lot of junk, kind of oddball junk, it's some Wish. Some of you might know the store Wish.com. I thought about ordering some stuff off of Wish and seeing what it's capable of doing, you know. Again, the products that I've been looking at are kind of one of those. If you buy it and it turns out to be utter, complete crap, don't be alarmed. Don't be like, oh, damn, this thing, you know. It's one of those don't be alarmed kind of thing, but yeah. Now, as like, again, for the future go-kart builds, I'm still on that. I'm still trying to, one, find a company, you know, that will, like a fabricating company that would help do the welding project. Some people are like, oh, you can get a cheap welder for this and that, but again, I know about those cheap Harbor Freight welders. I've been to Harbor Freight. I know all about those cheap welders, but I just don't think my electrical service panel can handle any sort of welders whatsoever. So that's why I'm not even going to try to attempt it, you know, and stuff, because the place where I do videos at and the garage workshop that I have, I just doesn't make sense. It won't. The electrical service panel, I don't think, can handle it. And just to be extra safe, I'm not even going to try to attempt it. It probably could, and I just don't realize it, but I'm not an electrician person, so I don't think the amps, breaker amps, would handle a welder that you can just plug into or a standard household outlet. I know they also, that they make those kind of welders that you can just plug into a regular household, what is it, 110 outlet, and be just fine. But I don't think the actual service electrical panel would be able to handle. I think what would happen is I would try to arc the welder to get it going, and it would just trip the circuit breaker where I'd be out X amount of dollars. Like, yep, that I knew that, you know. So it'd be one of those where I'd be trying to. I'd buy one of those types of welders, try to weld with it, and it would just trip the circuit breaker, and I'd be like, yep, I thought that would happen, and so I'm not even going to chance it. That's why I'm just going to, later on, when I find a company that can do that around me, then when I get the funding and the money, then I'll send the frame off to have it welded or whatever. Or I might end up having friends and people I know that see this video that know welding, and they might offer to help. Yeah, I'll help turn that boat trailer frame into a go-kart for you and stuff. And what I want to do with that frame, it wouldn't be that hard to personally do. It's just simply, all I want to do with that is just simply widen it out a little bit and then make it a little bit longer and figure on the actual frame, so I have room, obviously, for the set, two seats and stuff. And so with that project, all it is basically to add two seats to it and make it like a two-seater for where you can kind of squeeze two adults in there a little comfortably. You know, I saw some on Amazon, some types of seats that kind of they're geared towards that I saw that are kind of for like people are restoring like Volkswagen Beetles and stuff from like the 60s and 70s. And I saw some seats on there that I thought would be perfect for the go-kart build. And then that would be, it's just basically extend it out, wide it out, make it kind of a little bit more of a two-seater, you know, where you can kind of somewhat fit two people comfortably, and then just make it a little bit longer, obviously, for the leg room and motor room where you'd have room. Because the idea is to eventually put the motor in the front, and then build like a little frame up top and build like a firewall to build a firewall and then have room for the motor as well and stuff. So yeah, so that's what I'm gonna try to do with that project there, and when I able to do that, you will see videos of that in the future and stuff. Matter of fact, I still gotta finish the actual quitting off the rust on that, but yeah. And then with the tiny house build project, I also, for both of these projects, I still gotta look into getting a pickup truck or a cargo van or something of that nature and stuff still in the near future, looking for that. So yeah. But yeah, that's basically what's going on right now, is trying to figure out how to do videos with little to no money and stuff. And I hope, you know, I hope you people who watch my talk videos, I hope it encourages you, you know, to try to get out there and be something of your life. You know, that's what my personal goal is, again, with YouTube, starting out on YouTube, I thought it would be a great way for me to start out to try to become a somebody, you know, and try to make something of my life instead of just being a bum, you know. That's what I call it. I figure before I did start out on YouTube, I was just kind of a bum, and I thought, you know, I gotta figure out how to make something better of myself, and I thought YouTube would be a great way to become a somebody. And I hope my channel and videos and even this video encourages your people to start your goals and dreams and ideas, you know. Right now, my goal and idea is to build up a YouTube channel, start making money with YouTube, and then figure out how I can use YouTube as a way to somehow maybe down the line start up my own business of some sort. Like I talked about building a vintage car from the 1900s, my own kind of design and style. And I thought what would be neat to do with that, if I was successful at building like a prototype, then be able to down the line maybe make a business, so building them and selling them, or maybe, who knows, building little tiny houses. I don't know, those are two ideas I kind of had, you know, maybe build a little tiny house and make a business selling tiny houses around my area. I know that would be neat, because far as I know, in my area of Michigan, there ain't really many construction businesses or anything out there that build tiny houses. Now, when it comes to auto mechanic skills and building skills, I have none of that, but it doesn't hurt to try and see what you can come up with, you know. And again, and me not having those skills, and me trying to do these projects, I think would be great. Another way to encourage people who may not have a whole lot of skills themselves, and they might not simply have a whole lot of training and skills and certain things, to encourage them to go out and try and stuff, you know, because, and encourage them to maybe go try their hand at whatever and stuff. And that's basically my ultimate goal is to prove to people that, you know, you can become successful with little to no money and basically having nothing and having minimum skill sets. Like me, I have minimum skill sets, so, and me doing YouTube and stuff is just my way of trying to help people and hopefully encourage people to become some to make something of themselves and stuff. So, and when I later on down the line become well-to-do type person, if God lets me become that well-to-do person, I also money-wise want to be able to help people out, you know, and be able to help the homeless and people around my area and people that know me and be able to be one of those guys, because I also think it would be fun to be the person that, you know, some guy standing on a street corner with a tin can begging for change, be able to drop 10 grand in his cup and say, there you go live your life and you know, try to make a difference in the world and stuff. So yeah, this video is over 20 minutes long. I guess I'll end this kind of talk video. I hope you was able to stick around to start and finish. I do understand if you didn't make it through the whole video, because 20 minutes long, it is a long video, you know, and most people's lives, the way it is nowadays, it can be a little hard to sit and watch a 20-minute long video. But hope you all have a good day, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that red subscribe button down below, and comment below whatever you'd like, and give this video a thumbs up, share it with everyone you know, and I hope this video, you find it encouraging or interesting or something at least, you know. Thank you for watching.